स्मरण भव
सियापति रामचंद्र की जय। Time went on, and the people of the kingdom of Ayodhya lived in peace and harmony. While Sri Ram was king, there were happy families with no widows to lament. No parent led the funeral pyre of their child. There was no fear of diseases. Every creature was full of joy and happiness. Everyone was engaged in pursuit of dharmic actions, and turning their eyes, their focus, and their hearts towards Sri Ram alone, mankind did not seek to kill or bring harm to one another. Sri Ram, being a prudent king, one day sent out his messengers into the city of Ayodhya to observe its citizenry, to be his eyes and ears, and to listen to the comments and thoughts of the subjects on his rule as the king of Ayodhya. The messengers went out into the city to carry out his orders. Some of the messengers overheard the subjects of Ayodhya speaking very highly of Sri Ram with great love and affection.
Our Lord, Prabhu Sri Ram, is a great and humble king. The people of Ayodhya are blessed and happy to have him. Jai Sri Ram!
However, one of the messengers heard quite the opposite of such comments. As he passed the abode of a dhobi, the dhobi's eyes were red with anger, and he spoke to his wife threateningly with great venom in his voice.
You dare to stay at the house of another for a day? I will not accept you. I am not Sri Ram. Leave, leave and go. I will not accept a wife like you. Jau, jau!
The messengers were to report to Sri Ram about what they had heard and seen that day. They each took their reports to him, and his heart was full as he listened to what the first messengers had to say. As he reached the last messenger, Sri Ram noticed that he did not look eager to speak.
Oh, messenger, tell me, what have you seen? What have you heard? It looks as though something has troubled you.
The messenger recounted the events of that day to Sri Ram. The words of the dhobi struck Sri Ram like a thunderbolt. He could not imagine such ill thoughts being formed against Sita Ma.
Oh, messengers, I would like to speak to my brother Lakshman alone. You have done well.
But the comment was made, and Sri Ram knew he had to act. And so preparations were made for Sita Ma to leave Ayodhya, as she left all the luxuries of her life in Ayodhya behind. Lakshman ji, with a heavy heart, being obedient to his lord Sri Ram, escorted her to the forest where she would now reside. Lakshman led the way out of Ayodhya as Sita Ma left the city for the last time. And Lakshman reached the forest where he bowed and they parted ways. Sita Ma was now alone. No palatial luxuries to comfort her, no Sri Ram, exposed to the elements, all while carrying her babies. She soon came across Valmiki Muni.
I've been brought here by my brother-in-law Lakshman, and I have nowhere else to go.
O Devi, I am a great associate of your father, Raja Janak. Please let me associate you to a safe place to stay at my ashram.
And so, Sita Ma, leaving her previous life behind, began a very simple existence. She tended to the daily duties of the ashram and maintained a beautiful environment. She assisted with the cleaning. She planted beautiful flowers, which she then used to prepare for pujas. No matter what, she remained steadfast in her devotion as she prepared for the birth of her twin boys.
It is almost time for the arrival of my sons. I anxiously await to hold them in my arms. Prabhu, please bless them and guide them.
Some time passed and Sita Ma became the mother of twin boys named Love and Kush. They were ideal boys in all that they did. They served their guru, Valmiki Muni, with unwavering loyalty and respect. As they grew, he taught them about dharmic living, the scriptures, philosophy, and the art of warfare. They injected life and light and laughter into the ashram as they ran about and played their mischievous games. They were loving sons who were devoted to their mother in thought, word, and deed. They treated her with great love. Every morning, they would seek her blessing by touching her feet. They spoke to her lovingly and enjoyed telling her about their education and their good. They thought their whenever they were wrong in their actions and showed her utmost respect. Every day they joined a family as a family in praising Prabhu Sri Ram. Raja Ram ruled as a great and noble king. The kingdom was teeming with excitement as preparations were underway for the Ashwamedha Yagya. The Ashwamedha Yagya was a noble rite, one of the grandest Vedic religious rites. Raja Ram would conduct puja and release a horse which was to roam the land, the neighboring kingdoms of Ayodhya. The entire city gathered to show their love and support for their king.
Yeah.
yagya commenced. The citizens of Ayodhya gathered at the palace to witness Raja Ram engage in puja. It was time for Sri Ram to prepare to release the horse, which would bear the crest of the Raghu dynasty. If other kings did not capture the horse, they were deemed to accept the rule of Raja Ram and would be aligned to him. If they did not accept Raja Ram, they would capture the horse and would then have to fight his army. As the horse was about to be released, the citizens anxiously waited to hear the words of the king.
Citizens of Ayodhya, today we have performed Ashwamedha Yagya. The success of this Yagya will bring continued peace in our kingdom. It will ensure that our kingdom is prosperous and fertile. It will ensure camaraderie between other kingdoms and our kingdom, and ensure that we uphold our dharmic way of life.
Raja Ram Chandra Ki Jai. And finally, the horse was released with the prayers of Raja Ram and the people of Ayodhya behind it. Forest and eventually to the ashram of Valmiki Muni. Love and Kush were out playing and saw the majestic horse bedecked with the finest jewels. They immediately took a liking for it and decided to capture it for themselves. They tied the horse near the ashram and began to pet it and play with it. Raja Ram dispatched soldiers to follow the horse so they could alert Ayodhya in the event the horse was captured. The soldiers called out to Love and Kush.
Children, you must release this horse at once. Children, this horse belongs to Raja Ram. You must release this horse.
Children, this is not a game. Release this horse or you have to fight.
The boys continued to hold on to the horse, and so the soldiers challenged them to battle. Love and Kush, having learned the art of warfare from their guru, easily defeated the soldiers. The soldiers stunned at their loss against these two young boys headed quickly back to Ayodhya to report what happened. Raja Ram, not fazed by the reports of the soldiers, decided to send his three brothers to investigate. Bharat, Lakshman, and Satrughan made their way to the forest and came upon the captured horse and the twin boys, Love and Kush. Once again, the boys refused to release the horse. This led to a battle between Love and Kush and Bharat, Lakshman and Satran. The boys fought valiantly, and with the power of their father, Raja Ram, and the Shakti of their divine mother, they were able to defeat Bharat, Lakshman and Satran in battle. And so the three brothers returned to Ayodhya to report what happened. They told Raja Ram that they could not defeat the boys. And so, Sri Ram then sent his most trusted and most devoted messenger, Lord Hanuman. He who had the most loving and innocent nature. He who would do anything for his divine Lord.
यह संकट का हो सो जात न टारो देवन आनी करी विनती तब छाणी दियो रवि कष्ट निवारो.
Hanuman ji made his way into the forest and finally came upon the captured horse and the young boys. As he laid his eyes on them, he began to think to himself, my mind tells me that these are no ordinary boys. There's something special about them. Something that I have only witnessed with my Lord, Prabhu Sri Ram, and my divine mother Sita Ma. These boys possess the divine nature that only his Lord Prabhu Sri Ram could possess. He didn't fight the boys. He couldn't, for he knew that these were the sons of his Lord Prabhu Sri Ram. He bowed to them, and the boys captured Hanuman ji.
That we capture these animals. She will definitely make us some pilories later.
A messenger of Raja Ram witnessed what transpired. He could not believe that Hanuman allowed himself to be captured so easily. Why didn't he fight back? Concerned, he made his way back to Ayodhya to inform Raja Ram of what happened. Sri Ram, after learning of the events that transpired, arrived at the forest. He saw the majestic horse that he released at the start of his yagya, and he saw the two young boys who captured it. He saw his most trusted messenger, Hanumanji, tied up as well. He addressed the young boys, thinking that they were simply being mischievous young boys.
Oh, little boys, release this horse at once. This horse is part of the Ashwamedha yagya. Failure to release this horse will result in war.
The boys once again refused. Sri Ram, having warned the boys of the consequences of their actions, drew his arrow and sword. Love and Kush drew their arrows, and at the very moment where they were going to release their arrows, Sita Ma rushed between them, her husband on one end, her sons on the other. Raja Ram was stunned on seeing Sita Ma. She clasped her hands and said,
"Oh Prabhu, if you are to shoot Lav and Kush, who are your sons, then your arrow will have to hit me first. My sons, if you are to shoot your father, then you would have to shoot me first. I do not wish to live if I have to see my sons and my husband fight each other in this manner."
Lav and Kush immediately lowered their arrows. They could not defy their mother. They could not challenge their father. Sri Ram and Lav and Kush retracted their arrows and ran towards each other and embraced. They basked in the love of their father, having been away from him for their entire lives. They looked around for Sita Ma, but she was already a distance away from them.
"Oh Mother Earth, I have done my duty with love and devotion to my husband and children. I have remained steadfast and pure in my devotion, and I plead with you, Ma, please accept me in your divine embrace."
Mother Earth couldn't deny the sincerity of Sita Ma, and the earth opened up and Sita Ma sat on the throne of Mother Earth. Love, Kush and Raja Ram had no time to get to her. Before they could reach Sita Ma, the earth accepted her back into its embrace.
Sita!
Already gone.
"My boys, you must pay respect to your mother." "My sons, my heart hurts me to know that I have been away from you for so long. But I know that you were raised with such love, sincerity, and devotion. You two are highly skilled and intelligent and possess great discipline. Please accompany me back to Ayodhya. Come home to your family."
Sita Ma is an example of a dutiful, prayerful, and virtuous woman. She never turned her back on her devotion despite the hardships she faced. She was a loving and devoted mother, one who raised sons who loved each other fiercely and who could protect each other, who served and obeyed their mother, who dared not go against their father, sons who were versed in the scriptures and who served their guru. Sons who knew the importance of prayer and living a dharmic life. She raised sons who were groomed to follow the footsteps of their father and the noble dynasty from which he came, to uphold honesty, integrity, cleanliness, compassion, humility. Sons who would make their parents proud. Sons who were fit to carry on the Raghu dynasty. Sitaram, please give a round of applause for all cast members. You want to avoid harm, then chant
Bolo Shri Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Jai Sita Ram. Bolo Shri Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam, Jai Radhe Shyam.
You want to have calm and charm, then chant
Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram, Patita Pavan Sita Ram. Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram, Patita Pavan Sita Ram. Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram, Patita Pavan Sita Ram.
Bolo bolo Ayodhya Nath Siyapati Ram Chandra ki Jai. Thank you.
He annadhan ki maharani, o jai lakshmi.
Kendra dance group. This dance was choreographed by Vijay Siramlal. Our dancers are Abhi, Avita, and Anita. And this song that they will be dancing is the very famous Ghar More Pardesia from the beautiful movie Kalank. Please welcome our dancers. Thank you so much. This brings us to the end of our very short, relatively short, but sweet program. Thank you for your attention. We do hope you enjoyed.
Bole Shri Mahalakshmi Mata Ki Jai. Devotees, on my own behalf, on behalf of the Mandir, we want to say to these individuals, blessings to you. You made something that seemed difficult very easy. The play, everything flowed very smoothly. It's good coordination, good direction, good supervision, good acting. Everything was appropriate. The relevance of the play, the music, the dialogue, as well as the acting.
Sitaram, everyone. Firstly, I want to thank each and every one of you for coming out tonight. It's a pleasure to have you here. What you saw tonight was the product of, I'm not going to lie, we were a little delayed in our preparations for Diwali program on Ram Leela this year. But in the space of one short month, we were able to pull off what I would hope was a good play. I guess I'll get some feedback from the audience afterwards. But what I really want to focus on is our actors. I remember when we were looking for persons to act in the Ram Leela, we went out to the little ones in the temple, and persons like Kamil, Bhavesh, who was so shy before, and he delivered his lines so well on the stage after just a few practices. So I really want to commend them. Chandani, who wanted to only work on props but ended up featuring as Sita Ma. So there are so many names to call, I don't want to forget anyone out, but I want to encourage you all to bring especially the younger ones out to the temple. There is something good here. We had so much fun in preparations for this play. There were a lot of laughs in practice. You can ask any one of the cast members, but there is a family here. There is love at Om Shakti. Your children would be in good hands here. So that is my message to you, I suppose. As this is Diwali time, let us remember our religion, our culture, what it really is about. So, Shubh Diwali, everyone. Thank you for coming. And I hope to see many more of you in our Ram Leela next year.